ships of an alien source are approaching from the sky. Radio contact is attempted but cannot be assessed. Instructions are to prepare for an attack by
Yo, we're back for another podcast. We got Sammy Sam. We got motherfucking our dude over there,
all stomach guzzler.
Chill, on the ones and twos.
I already know.
Yeah, and we're back, man. Last time we left off, we were talking about a crazy story this guy had over here. Should we start off there? What do you think, Oz?
Shit, might as well.
Yeah.
Let's see, we want to hear about this alien interaction you had back in the day.
Yeah, because we didn't want to give them too much. You know, yeah. We didn't want to give them too much. Where they're not going to come back, you know, because if they heard the story on the last episode, they're not coming back.
No. Nah.
You think they're going to come back?
No, you give Hell them a little nah. taste test, a little sampler.
Little Costco it. Sampler.
Little banana bread at Costco. Shit. And you know. Bubble guts afterwards. That's why they have a restroom.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
let's start it off with that, man. Tell us the rest, or let's just start from the beginning. What happened, man?
I'll tell you what happened. I had this ritual where in Yonkers, originally, when you have a pit bull, you try to keep your dog conditioned, just like yourself, because you never know when something's going to go down.
Conditioned like what? Like weights?
Like,
and all that,
meaning they're health-wise, running them, so they have cardio. With cardio and running, you build a little more muscle, what you feed them with and so forth. So I moved to Albany, New York, and I got my dog with me, and I got my girlfriend at that time, and I'm going to go to the park. It's after work, finish cutting hair, we close at 7:30, got to go home, it's like 15 minutes away, do what I got to do, grab my dog, harness, softball, you know, the whole kit and caboodle, head over to the park in Troy, New York. It's an outskirt of Albany, New York. Mm-hmm. So we head out to the park, and it's me, my girlfriend at the time, and my dog. And I had a 1992 Toyota Celica ST. It was rolled down windows, no automatic locks. In order for me to unlock that car, I got to put the key inside the door, lock, and unlock it. No AC. No sunroof.
This is before the RX-7.
This is after the RX. I had an RX-7, was my first car, and then I downgraded.
Oh, no.
I mean, I didn't, though. It was newer. The RX-7 was an 86, and then I stepped into a 92 Toyota Celica. This is 1998. It's a six-year-old car. Drives like a new car and everything. It drove really good. It was stick shift. It just didn't have, you know, all the amenities that I wish it had. But that's fine. So we get in a car. We go to the park. It's about, I'd say about between 8:30 and 9:30 at night. And I'm throwing the ball around. My dog would fetch it, bring it back to me. But he'd lay down. He wouldn't bring it to me. He just wanted to be next to me. And he would lay down and start chewing this big softball. Uh-huh. And I'd tell him to drop it. He'd let it go, but he'd hover over it like he wanted to grab it again. And I'd grab it real quick with all the saliva on it. And I'd make him sit and lift it up in the air, tell him to sit. And then I would throw it, and he would go running after it. And we would just continuously do that. He'd get his workout on. So we're in the middle of this big park. It's two softball fields. So we're in the park, and I'm throwing this ball around. This is 1998, maybe 98. And throwing the ball around. And, you know, it's at this time, you can't have a dog off the leash. It's illegal. I don't know if they still got that, but California is a different type of state. But in New York, you can't have a dog off the leash. And if you have a pit bull, they want you to have insurance on the dog, $1 million insurance policy, and you have to have a non-vicious license with you.
Uh-huh.
Which you have to have taken your dog to the shelter, and they would test your dog. They would try to jump at your dog to see if your dog was going to jump back at them and try to tear him up. If your dog sat there, they write on this piece of paper, non-vicious license. They give it to you. You buy it. You're good. So I'm in the park, and we're throwing the ball around. And
what time is it at?
It's between 8:30 p.m. Eastern time and 9:30 p.m.
So there's no sun. It's dark.
There's no sun. It's dark. There's no lights in the park. We're getting a glimpse of the moon is what's giving us that little bit of light.
Oh, okay.
In the park. So it's pretty dark, but you can kind of, you could see, but you can't really see too far. It starts to become more like a figure than you can actually see. But at this, where this area that I'm at, there's a hill. There's a steep little hill with a monument sitting on top of it. Mm-hmm. It's a stone monument. It's stone. It goes straight up and then to a point. And at the bottom of it, it's like in memory of John, whatever, you know.
Yeah.
John Doe from whatever that they probably built that park in memory of him. So throwing the ball around and all of a sudden I see this movement happening in the woods. Mm-hmm. A little distance away, I'd say maybe like 50 yards away, I could see this movement in the woods. And it looked like an egg shape. And it wasn't bobbing up and down. It was just like floating. So in my mind, I immediately thought, oh, it's 8:30 at night. There's a guy on a mountain bike with headgear, a helmet, and it's got to be a white guy because ain't no Hispanic or black in New York riding with a helmet at 8:30 at night.
Yeah, there's no way.
We on a BMX or something moving.
Yeah.
But he's in the woods, so he ain't on a BMX, and it's late at night, and he's not afraid of anything.
Was it like, did he have a flashlight on him or what? Was it like, did it have a light on it or?
No. I could just see like in the woods, I can see that it was like an off-white, like a grayish color because it was in the dark, but the moonlight was hitting it so you can see slightly and it was lighter. It would have been dark or like a shadow looking, but it was white.
Yeah.
So my mindset, I was like, you know, you kind of like we're talking about judging in your mind, you calculate something because you guesstimate what you think it is. Yeah. And I was like, that's a guy on a bike. And he's just going in the opposite direction of us. So I seen him and I just kept throwing the ball and I saw him. And I thought, my dog is 85 pounds, you know, of muscle, lean and tall. And when he runs, it sounds like a horse. Yeah. He's like, he's tearing up the grass, bro. When he's running, it's turning into dirt. So he's got like running. And I see the guy stop. Now I don't see the guy. All I can see is like his helmet because there's a bunch of woods and bushes and stuff. But I'm guesstimating it's a guy with a helmet because it's moving in midair and it's not bobbing. So it isn't somebody walking. It's just floating across.
Yeah.
So I'm like, it's got to be a guy on a bike. So I got my attention on him and I'm throwing the ball, but I'm kind of just making sure that, you know, there's no like... He doesn't like see us because you're gonna say, hey man, your dog's not on a leash.
Yeah.
So he stops and he starts coming back towards us.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yo, he saw us just like I saw him and he's hearing the dog and he could see it and he's now gonna complain and he's gonna tell us you shouldn't be in the park.
Yeah.
So I'm like, damn. All right. So when he gets close by, my mindset, I'm gonna grab my dog by the collar, put the leash back on him and walk off with my girl and my dog.
Yeah.
So he's coming back and then I can't see him anymore because there's a bunch of bushes and trees and I'm thinking he must have ended up walking behind something while he's walking towards us and it's blocking him until he hits a certain angle and then I'll see him again. So I already know he's coming. I'm kind of annoyed. So I'm definitely not keeping my attention off of that. I got to, because he's going to come and say some stuff, and he's going to call the cops, and he'll probably take down my license plate. So, no. I had an incident with the cops before. That's another story with my dog, with another dog that I had. So I'm watching him, and then I don't see him anymore. But I keep my attention in that area, and I'm just throwing the ball at my dog. All of a sudden, I start seeing the bushes move. So I'm like, here he comes. And when I see the bushes move, now at this point in time, he's probably about 30 yards away. So it's pretty close. When I see the bushes move, I see a being come from the bushes, and it's low, and the eyes glowed like a reflector.
What the fuck?
So this is very true, man. I don't care if people believe it or not. This is what I saw. I know what I saw. I said this story a million times, and it never changes. Yeah. So it's a dog.
Okay. So like when like a cat or a dog when yeah yes, I know
sir.
Yeah, okay.
And it's a reflector, not yeah. glowing, and it's sitting there.
Yeah, it just
no, it just
yeah,
went they got shing.
Some, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And when I saw it, I knew it was a dog.
Okay.
Because where the head was, you know, where the eyes were, and when it came out the bushes, I saw it walking on four legs, and it was the height of a dog, and I could tell.
Yeah.
I used to watch a lot of animal. I still do to this day. Animal, nature.
Yeah.
We used to have the five super predators. We used to buy a VHS tapes and watch all this. I love animals.
Wait. So it went from being tall?
No.
To
yes.
like, yeah, to it, now no, it's lower?
I don't know if it went. All I know is I seen something moving, coming towards us. Maybe it went away. I don't know.
No. But when you seen it from a distance going the opposite direction,
it was taller, right? It was a tall thing, and I swore that it was a man on a mountain bike.
And then when it get closer,
it was short, it was shorter. Like the size of a dog. It came through the bushes, and when I seen the eyes reflect, I knew what time it was. It's a dog, and I'm thinking that has nothing to do with that guy.
Oh, you thought of something else.
I'm like, oh, shit, there's a dog.
So where you thought that the guy went?
I have no idea. My attention now is on this dog because I have a pit bull, and my pit bull isn't majorly aggressive, but he'll bang out if he gets startled. And they say that anger is
he bangs out.
Anger comes from a trigger, you know, it's triggered from fear.
Yeah.
You know, when somebody scares you, you're like, oh, damn, stupid. Like, why are you playing games for?
Yeah.
So I'm thinking like, all right, this is going to happen.
Might be a fight or something.
So this dog comes out of the bushes and I see it. Mm. I can't see a dog. I'm guesstimating it from the height that it was and the eyes, and then I see it walking sideways, and it has the shape of a dog. I don't see the tail. I could see the legs and the body, and I'm like, that's a dog. I'm not stressing it. It's a dog.
Yeah.
And it's walking, and it starts to, instead of come towards us, it's circling us like a wolf.
Yeah.
And I'm like, my mentality, I came from Yonkers, New York. You know, they fight pit bulls and stuff out there. So it ain't no thing. I'll let my dog bang out with another dog, and then I'm going to jump in and be stomping that dog. So he starts walking around us, and he's looking at us. Yeah. And he's walking like he's stalking us. And I'm like, I'm looking at you, stupid. Like, you crazy? So he keeps walking, and I'm watching it. So I'm like, play games. I'll throw the ball over there. And I'll never forget this. I say it all the time. And I envisioned my dog running for the ball and distracted at the ball, you know, for the ball. And he really wants this ball bad. But when I throw it over there and it goes next to that animal and he sees it and looks up, it's going to startle him, which is going to make him mad. And it's his ball and it's in his comfort zone. And they're gonna bang out. Mm-hmm. And I got confidence in Onyx. Mm-hmm. He's the bang out. He banged out here and there by mistake a few times. So I'm like, he's gonna bang out with this dog, and I'm gonna run over there, and I'm gonna kick the shit out of this dog.
Mm-hmm.
So he starts circling us, and I'm watching him. He's walking in a half moon shape. He doesn't circle us 360. He walks in a half moon shape, but not fully. And he starts climbing, starts walking up that hill, that steep hill. And it's a short, small, steep hill that's maybe, I don't know, maybe 10 feet tall, but the incline is serious. And I used to run my dog up that hill. I would throw the ball so he can pull himself so he could work his chest and his shoulders and his arms.
Yeah.
So I seen him walking up the hill. And I'm like, what's this thing doing? And it's stands right in front of that monument and sits down. And I'm like, yo, this is crazy. I'm looking dead. What are you doing?
How far are you from it at this point?
Probably like 30 yards because he went like in a half moon. He's not coming towards us. He's like in a half moon like this. So it's still the same distance,
uh-huh.
but just circled us now. He's on a different angle of us, but I'm now facing him.
And to get to your car, do you have to walk past there or no?
No.
Okay.
To get to my car, I got to go back the other way.
All right.
So I see him, and he walks up, and I'm kind of, I'm intrigued, bro. I'm like, he got my attention. I'm like, what is he doing?
What is he going to do next?
Like, what is he doing now? He's just staring at us.
Yeah.
So he starts standing up.
Standing up.
And I'm like, wait, what? I could see he's sitting in front of this monument, and the moon is hitting it. It's a stone monument. It's, you know what I mean? It's like,
yeah,
you know? So it's a light gray, and it goes up to a point. And I see him, his dark figure, and it's covering the stone. And I'm like, and he starts getting up taller. And I said, wait a second. That ain't a dog. I don't know why, bro. I'm going to tell you, this is a fact. This is the truth. At first I thought, and this is going to sound stupid, bro. Is that a koala bear?
What the fuck? Koala bear.
This was my thought.
Yeah.
I'm trying, my brain is starting to try to calculate what is this. The reason why I thought it was a koala bear was because I seen it rising up on that stone, and I thought, is this thing climbing?
Oh, okay.
And it just, that was my first thought. Okay, I'm going to keep it a buck. This is what I thought. I know it sounds stupid. We're not in Australia.
Or how about just a regular bear? Or do you guys not have bears?
Hold
over
on.
There?
This. Yeah, you're hitting it. See what you just thought? I'm so glad you said that. Because everybody knows this is what I said. But I could see that the figure's starting to get bigger. And I could see still the dark figure on the floor.
Yeah.
Covering that stone. So I said, that's a bear. What's going to be crawling this whole time? Eyes reflected.
Yeah.
And now standing up super tall. That's a bear. But it was growing past it. And it was skinny. And it kept growing taller. And now I'm in the state of shock, bro. I got goosebumps right now. I'm in a state of shock.
Yeah. That's
what the I'm is 20 years old. I'm with a girl that is my girlfriend at the time.
Yeah.
My dog. And at this moment in time, I was renting an apartment, the first apartment I ever had my whole life. Mm-hmm. I was living with my brother and my cousin and myself. And then she would leave clothing there a lot of times. And she's kind of just living there. So I'm at the park at this moment.
Yeah.
And I see this thing growing. Now, she is a gangster, not gangbanging. She's one of those people that she got an issue with you. And there's, you know, there was already words or something on the phone. Oh, she's on site on top of you. She's pounding
ready
you.
Ready to scrap.
Yeah.
Not ready to scrap. She's scrapping you.
So we got two people and a dog that's ready to bang out at any 100%. Moment. Any
yep.
moment.
100%. And I'll be honest, I wasn't a bang out dude, but if I had to, I did what I had to do. But I was no gangster. She was tougher than me. No, that's a fact, bro. Because I used to say, damn, I wish I had a little piece of what she got.
Yeah.
Because I would be a little different with dudes that are, you know what I mean, slimy. So anyway, I see this thing growing up, and it's so tall. And I look at her, and she looks at me, and she goes, what the fuck is that? And I said, I don't know. Run. And she starts running, bro, to my car.
Yeah.
I gave her a chance, bro. Yeah, I know it's not going to sound good. Everybody wants to be a tough guy.
This lady probably.
I didn't leave her.
Everybody's going to have their oh, I would have did this.
Yeah.
But they didn't live this moment.
Yeah, but they
I was in a state of shock because it wasn't like I was afraid of somebody. It was something that was so overwhelming. I didn't know what was going on. I was in a state of shock. The fear, my heart dropped to my stomach, to my ass.
Yeah.
I was like, I was terrified.
So wait, how high did it grow? Like, what's the last time you seen it when it grew?
I would say this thing was growing to about like 8 feet.
Oh, fuck that.
Maybe a little over 8 feet.
So for sure not a bear then.
Nah, I was skinny, bro, and tall.
Yeah.
Slender.
Skinny.
Man.
Skinny, like, okay.
So I look at her, she looks at me, and she just, like, I'm getting chills. I'm like, I don't know what to do.
Yeah.
I'm in a state of shock. I've never seen this my whole life. It's like a nightmare, bro. So I look at her, and she's like, what the fuck is that? And I'm like, I don't know. Run, 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 run. And I got the ball in my hand.
Yeah.
And I go to my dog, and I throw it to wherever that thing was.
What the hell? Why'd you do that?
Because I knew it was, because when I looked at it, yeah, and I looked at her, you ever seen two people bump into each other at a public place or whatever, and they got issues and they didn't know that one was going to be there, and one gets up and pokes his chest out like, well, yo, what's up, bro?
Uh-huh.
He kind of, or whatever that was, had that same body posture. He stood up and it poked his chest out like we were prey. I never felt that feeling in my life. I've been jumped. I've been chased. You know what I'm saying? This feeling was something so terrifying, bro.
Yeah.
I've been in bad situations. This was like unbelievable. This was of like a nightmare, bro. Like a dream when you wake up and you're like, oh my God. Wow. Like, was that like shit, thank God. Real? Like, because that's, you ain't getting beat up. You ain't about to get killed. This is like, you don't even know what's going to, like the Predator, like yeah, the movie.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's like seeing something like that fear.
Yeah.
And the way that thing looked at us and the way the body shape was, how it just like, was like, so like you're done, bro.
Mm-hmm.
So, and the way that it morphed and changed, I knew we was done. I had the fear at that moment when he stuck his chest out. Immediately what came to my mind, bro, when I turned around to run, was I felt like Jeepers Creepers, like he was on the hill.
Yeah.
And he was just going to go and fly down, like low to the ground, and just hit me and then destroy me, like rip me, whatever he was going to do. And why he, you know what I mean? Why he was there. Yeah. I don't know. That's the way I felt.
Yeah.
Anyway, I looked at her. She said that. I took the ball. And when I threw the ball, people were like, what did it do? A boy. As soon as I released that ball, I was gone. Running, bro.
Gone.
I'm running.
Gone.
Down the park, and I could see her running.
He took off on him.
But I run twice as fast as her. She got short strides. I used to make fun of her. I'm running, and I'm running for my life, and I feel like it's coming from my back. It's about to, it's a, the way that he looked like I'm going to give you a head start. Ready? Now I'm coming. Because he knew he was going to get me.
And how far were you from the car?
Two softball fields away, bro.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, okay.
Where was Onyx at that time then when you were running off?
He went for the ball.
Took the ball and I threw it.
He sacrificed the dog.
I put him in the way. He's dying first.
Yeah.
I turn around and I'm running. I see her. I'm passing her really fast.
He should have tripped her.
As soon as I get behind her, maybe three strides behind her, I start screaming. I said it a few times, run faster, run fast. And I'm just gunning it past her. Mm. What am I going to pick her up like Captain America? I weigh 119 pounds, bro. She weighed 176. I'm running past her, dog. She was a thick girl.
He like them thick.
So, you know, at that time, she was a thicker, you know what I mean? Yeah. She wasn't like a fat girl, she was thick.
Yeah.
And I'm running past her, and I'm like, run faster. And I got to run past her to open the car. This ain't no automatic door lock. Got the key, and I got to put it in the door.
Jeez.
I'm running.
You either jumping in or you not. I'm gone.
I get to the car. I put the key in the door. By the time I get to the car, I hear heavy breathing. It's my dog. He's like, he was flying, bro.
Damn.
Daddy was gone. He was running to catch up with daddy. He gets up to me. I open up the door and I look and I could see her. And she's probably like a quarter way into the last
the softball
field. Just a quarter. She got three quarters to go, bro.
Yeah, like
she's like outfield getting to second base. And I'm like, hurry up.
Oh, hell.
I'm
nah.
like, and she's like, and she can't even run, bro. She's like walking and trying to trot. Like she's done. Like the nerves and the running killed her. Uh-huh. Like the adrenaline, she was like, she couldn't even run. I'm like, hurry up, run. And I'm opening up the door and I take the seat and I lift, because it's a two-door coupe, and I pull the seat forward and slide it forward. And my dog, I'm like, get inside. And he jumps in. I'm like, hurry up. I'm like yelling. She's trying. I'm like waiting for her. And she comes up. I get in the car while she's almost there and I turn it on and I unlock her door by hand. I lean over, I lock it, and she gets in the car like barely making it, bro. She gets in and I pull backwards and I just go. I get home and I'm freaking out. I'm like, yo. My brother's like, whoa. My brother's kind of like a hard dude and he used to be like a violent guy. He said, what happened? And I tell him what happened. And he goes and grabs his gun. My cousin's like, let's go do this. Let's go find it. What? And I'm like, you guys don't understand. I'll never go back. I don't care if the squad, the police department goes.
I ain't pulling back.
The fear that I felt was so
crazy. Heavy. Yeah.
I will never, ever, and have I ever, never, ever gone back. Ever. And I'll never forget it. It was in my mind. I could draw it on a piece of paper. I remember it like it was.
And since that day, have you like come across like maybe like online, like somebody else seen the same thing or like painted the same picture?
I was in Albany. I mean, in California.
Yeah.
It was about 2020. And the guy that I work with, I believe, he said, hey, man, that sounds like Slender Man.
Yeah.
Now, I didn't know what a Slender Man was.
Yeah.
I know about Bigfoot and the Loch Ness Monster and demons, but I never heard of a Slender Man.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, he's like, yo, you got to check it out. It's Slender Man. And I guess I did research on it, and I saw that it's a shape-shifting thing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what it was.
But that was like close. Like when you seen it, you're like, oh shit, maybe.
Yes, because it was tall and skinny and it was aggressive. The way that the posture was pretty aggressive and ready.
That's crazy how in the beginning you saw it as like someone riding a bike. But I'm saying like
the way you said it, like it went from that
to low, like a down animal, low.
Like a dog. Yeah.
So to I'm Christian, man. And I can't knock any other religion or any beliefs of any kind, but I have my own, and some people believe it was a demon. If I had to make up a story on what it was, like guess, it could have been a UFO or some energy or a UFO, and then it just came at us in one shape and then stood up in another shape. And was changing. I don't know.
What?
I don't know.
Yeah. What do you think it was, Oz? Huh? Like, what do you think you could, can you like kind of weigh in on this and see what you think? What do you think it was?
From the beginning, I said Slender Man because that's the way he said it, stood up tall and skinny. I was like, no way. But it's weird though. Like what you're saying, it shape-shifted. It went from, you said like a floating head basically to the dog. Then you thought it was a bear. And that's just...
And the eyes.
The glowing eyes.
Like was reflective. See, I ain't going to leave anything out. And never will. Because I know what I saw. When something traumatizes you like that, you're not going to forget. You ain't going to forget. No, and I'll never forget that. What are you talking about? This feeling of helpless, of feeling like prey, feeling like nothing.
Was not a good feeling at all.
One of the worst feelings I ever felt in my whole life. One of the worst... Probably the most fearful I've ever felt my whole life. Right there on the spot. And she was there to witness it. We didn't do drugs, and we saw the same thing. And I used to like to smoke here and there weed, and she would be like, nah. Yeah. I used to try to get her to smoke sometimes. At this time, I barely ever smoked.
But you weren't smoking that day, were you?
No. Definitely not.
Sober, straight edge.
No smoke and no drinking. I don't like drinking till this day, really, either.
Yeah.
Rare. Rare to see me drinking.
And like you said, he wasn't by himself.
Yeah.
So it's like,
that's crazy.
Nah, we both saw that, and I don't know, man. Like, I don't talk to her now like that, but, you know, I wish I could. Maybe she knows the answer that I don't know of, or, you know, it could have been something. It could have been an evil entity. Could have been following her, and I just saw it. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe.
I you know, I'm saying that, I'll be honest, because I still to this day always try to find an answer for it. So I tried to think of what it was. Was it
like what reason?
Was
why
it a spirit?
Yeah.
What did it have to do with that? A spiritual thing, or was it an alien? Yeah. I don't know.
Well, speaking about like in the same, I guess, topic, like that those glitches of the airplanes.
Yeah.
You know, like that is crazy because I seen one, right? It's, I guess, like the most recent where they're in a car, and you know it's passing. And it looks like it's floating. You know, just some people, there. But some people, you know, are saying like, oh, it's basic physics and this and that. And I get it because there are some videos where they try to make it seem like it's floating. It's not. You could tell that's a little bit moving. Yeah. But and then I seen this video. Watch, I'll show you. It's a video where this lady, she's actually walking. So she's not moving in the car and she's not going the opposite direction. She's just literally standing still. And the fucking plane's not moving, so I don't know what the fuck.
Keep walking.
Look.
Keep walking. Look.
See, it's just in the air. And she's not going the opposite direction, so I don't know.
Is it moving?
You know? You could hear it.
Moving?
You could hear it, but it's not moving. And the thing behind it is not moving either.
Oh, it's got the flag that yeah. Carrying that thing too?
Yeah, and it's
oh,
not
it's
moving.
Oh, it's definitely not moving. Look at it next to that cloud.
Yeah.
You can look off of what's around it, the surrounding of it, and you'll see that clear cloud with the darkness and ain't going nowhere. It's still in the same spot with
yeah.
the light.
Yeah, yep.
Yeah, it's barely moving. Oh, it moved a little
if
bit.
If anything, the clouds is moving. The clouds are probably moving. But
yo, he's windsurfing.
Yeah.
You know how birds sit there? They just keep floating while the wind is blowing yeah. underneath his wings.
Yeah. Oh, did you see the bird one? Where the bird's like yeah. this and it's fucking floating and yeah. someone's trying to hit it down.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know what the hell that's all about.
I think that it's really hard to believe anything nowadays because a lot of people have stories and they have positioned maybe a camera or something in a way that they caught a like something that looks like something and it really isn't. And they're like, oh, shit.
Yeah, people want to go
almost
viral.
Like if, it's almost like you ever seen a picture of like someone and their hands like this. And behind them is like the, let's just say the pyramid of Egypt, and it looks like they're holding
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah. It's like an illusion.
But, I mean, you're hearing the sound, man. It's barely even moving, and clouds move, and it's just there. And I don't doubt anything, though. I have doubt, and I don't. It's like anything goes, man. So it might be true, it might not be. I can't give a definitive answer because that's just like people judging me and what I saw.
Yeah. For real.
And I know what I saw, so, and I didn't share this story a lot back in the days, because I knew people were going to be like,
yeah, he's
come on, bro. But yeah. I think that with all us having technology now, and all of us having cameras, we're catching things that people couldn't catch. You had to be there for it, where everybody's there for it now.
Yeah.
So, I don't know if this is the end of the days, if, you know, if it's a spiritual warfare where Satan wants you to believe things, so they're going to put things out to take us away from what's really happening.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, like this, right? There's videos. I thought it was something new because that one video I saw recently, it was posted not too long ago. But actually, there's like fucking a lot of, if you go on YouTube, there's a lot of videos. And it was like years. There's videos going back from like 2 years, 3 years. So this shit has been happening. It's not anything new, I guess. It's just something that I caught on to.
But let me ask you this. So if there's a plane there, right?
Yeah.
Maybe there's a pilot in there. Then why is it frozen? Mm-hmm. What are we thinking after that? If it is true, what is it? Is it like the movie The Truman Show, where it's a fake, it ain't even a real plane. This whole world, is this a Matrix?
What is that?
Is there a glitch?
I've been wanting to watch that.
Oh, you got to see
with
that
Jim Carrey,
with Jim
right?
Carrey. It's going to make you think.
I seen the behind the scenes where Jim Carrey went crazy.
Yes, I love that.
I seen that.
Where he went nuts. This was?
Yeah.
Huh? What movie?
Truman Show.
Okay.
He was a real guy, right? And Jim Carrey played him?
Yeah, he was Andy Kaufman.
There you go, Andy Kaufman. Yep. And I heard he was a crazy dude.
He played him to the T so much that all his co-workers, the co-stars that worked with him were like, yo, it's so crazy to see this. It's him.
Well, they said that he was... It's because even like when cameras were shut off, he was still act like that.
He was carrying it through public.
Yeah.
The guy that died, Andy Kaufman, of cancer, his real daughter was at the set and was asking Jim Carrey, talk to me like you're my father, like my dad.
Oh, yeah.
Be Andy. Talk
I
to
did,
me.
Yeah.
And she was crying, bro. He had it nailed, bro.
Yeah.
He is a genius.
Jim Carrey?
Yeah, he's a genius, which makes him a weirdo. And what's weird really is I learned that weird is really different. Yeah. So he's so different. He's just like Kanye. They're just geniuses and they're different. So it's hard for us to be on that wavelength. It's all crazy for us.
To just think different.
But to them, we're just too simple minded. Yeah. But I don't know. I don't know. I couldn't explain this. That's crazy.
Who knows what's out there?
I don't believe that. And I hate to be like this, and I don't know if it's because I got gray in my beard, but you know how wise men, when you ask them for an answer, they give you back a riddle? You're just like, damn, that ain't an answer, though.
This man became the Riddler.
It's a question mark. I'm asking a question, and you answered it with a question. Now we're too deep. The question. I think that things may be true, they may be not. There's no one has the answer until we can all, I guess... experience something together.
Yeah, something like you experienced.
You know what I mean? But I've experienced more than that with her. I've seen many different things. Mm-hmm. So then I started to question, was it her? So like, not was she making it. Like, was this like following her?
Following her, like the I didn't think that she'd be making it. No.
Because she would be fearful. I was thinking something was attached or attracted to her. And I was with her, so I was seeing it.
You know what we should bring on to the show is like a medium.
I knew you were going to say that. I was going to say a psychic. I've dealt with one before and a few. And I know one right now. I know one I think she's a psychic. I was cutting her son's hair. And maybe we can get her on too. Yeah. But
I know one too. She just came to this studio actually. First thing, you know what the first thing she did when she came in here? She looked at me and was like, oh, there's somebody with you. And I'm like, what the fuck? Yeah. And I'm like,
was it like did you ask her, was it a good spirit, a bad spirit? What the fuck?
She was just telling me, oh, do you want to know? Like, before we started the show, she was like, hey, do you want to know? She asked everyone, because there's a couple of us in the room. She's like, you guys want to know, like, if anything comes, you know, in? And we're like, yeah.
Of course.
And then she was like, she just kept, like, picking at me, though. Like, oh, yeah, he's a, you know, she described a guy that was standing next to me. But I don't know who it was. I honestly didn't know who it was. I don't know who she was talking about. But yeah, we didn't get to get into it too deep because it wasn't my show. But I want to bring her on though. Maybe she could talk to us about
it. I met a guy in Walmart. We were in Walmart. This is crazy, bro.
This was out like, here?
Yep, Walmart out here in California, and the Walmart in Palmdale. And we were in Walmart, my nephew and I. My nephew's in his 20s. And I was gonna pay for my stuff. But I don't know if you've ever been in Walmart where the line is within the aisles of like clothing and stuff, because they're leaving that centerpiece open so people can walk through. So if you try to get to the register right now, you have to go in between the clothing behind those people because they got cars just sitting in between the clothing and stuff, the racks.
Yeah.
Waiting to... So this black dude didn't notice it. So he gets in the line and he looks back and he's like, oh. He looks at this dude that's waiting in between the clothing. He's like, oh, did that line start there? And he's like, yeah. He's like, oh. So he's like going to walk away. And I say, hey, bro, you were here before me. I watched the whole scenario. If you want, come in front of me. You could be behind that guy. Be in front of me. You'll be next, right after him. He was like, oh, you sure? I'm like, yeah, come on, man. You know, you were already here. That's only fair, man. You just didn't know. They don't have, everybody made that up. They don't have no arrows or anything telling you how to do that. So he's all right. So he gets in front of me. Now, here's the crazy part. That day, I was signing a lease. But I went, that day, I was working on the other place that I was living at. I went and bought material to fix up the patch kit and stuff to fix up the walls and stuff and paint before I leave. I want to leave the place looking nice.
Yeah.
And there was a hole in the wall from the doorknob. So he stands in front of me and he has his hair like dreaded short and he's wearing this cool chain. It's like wooden beads. And then it has like a stone and there's like copper wrapped around it, holding on to this little wooden beaded chain that he has. And he has this different style of like a bracelet made out of like wooden balls, beads.
Yeah.
And it looked cool. So he stands in front of us and then he turns around and he looks at me and he goes, you're a really good person, man. You like helping people. You're going to sign a contract today. I'm like,
what the
fuck? What? Now he's right.
Yeah.
I love helping people. That's why I want to be successful, just to give back. That's, I don't know. Call it what you want it, but because I ain't going to take any of this anyway.
Yeah, it ain't going.
If I bought a bunch of food and I become vegan and I got a bunch of meat, I want to give it to somebody else. If I can't return it, I'm not going to say, just throw it in the garbage. Hey, yo, you need this. Yo, you hungry? I got food, man. Come over. I got some frozen stuff I just bought. So he said that and I was like, and then he like, sorry, I just feeling your energy. You have really good energy, man. You're really good with your hands too. I'm like,
what the fuck? Hey,
man, Paul. Whoa! On,
Paul, did he hit him with the pause?
Yeah. Easy. Click.
Easy, buddy.
What are we talking about here?
Yo, that's crazy. And he's like, you're gonna sign a contract today. And then he looks back and he goes, you're gonna be a millionaire. Yeah, you're gonna be successful. But because you're a good person too, you deserve it. You just you have something with your family and you need to break that. But you're gonna be very successful. You'll be a millionaire. And I'm like, what? So then he looks at my nephew and he goes, this is so crazy because he's not my blood nephew, but I call him my nephew and he's so loyal that I just love it. I admire it so much that I'm like, that's my blood right there. Even though he's not, that's my blood. That's my boy.
Wait, this was recent?
This was recent.
Oh, okay.
It's with Pancho.
Oh, okay.
So he goes, he looks at him and he goes, and I was just having a conversation with him about a friend. And I'm like, yo, you need to pick and choose who your real friends are because some people get you in trouble or this and that. They're not on the same path, you know, that you're on and it could pull you away. It could do things like, we were talking about that earlier. So he goes, you're a really good person, man. You're very loyal. And I'm like,
this man was.
He goes, but you're pretty stubborn. You don't like to listen to people. You like to learn first. You bump your head and then you'll know whether you should have done that or not. And he is like that, like so bad. Like so bad.
Oh, he's talking about Pancho now.
Yeah, and he goes, just don't do the same thing twice if you know it's a mistake. But you're very loyal, man. He just kept saying that. I was like, Pancho's just quiet. He was like,
like taking it in.
And he looks at me and he's like, looks at Pancho and he's like telling him, stick with him, like, dude, he's a good dude. You guys can be very successful. And he goes to Pancho and he says, like basically trust yourself. Stop always just going with people and this, that. If you feel something, stick with it. Don't mess with them.
Yeah.
You got good instincts.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, and I'm like, what the hell? It was like, gang, 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 gang.
So what was the contract that he told you that you were going to sign? Was that true? Or?
I was signing a lease that day to move into my new place.
Oh, okay.
He's like,
okay,
you're going to sign a contract today.
You're like.
And I'm like, damn, I'm on my way to go.
Did you tell him that or no?
No.
Or you just kind of, okay.
No, I was like, yo.
He's like, how you know?
Because how often do you sign contracts? Yeah. That's a contract. Yeah. It's a lease, bro. I was like,
How about the family thing? What was that all about?
What?
When you say you had to break something off with your family.
I feel like it's with my family, I always, not my brothers and sisters, I think it's on my father's side, uh-huh. and they have like a negative outlook on certain things. Mm-hmm. So, you know, and I love them, but some of them have like this way about them, and I feel like they have a, they don't feel like they can really make it, because I've never seen anybody on that side, rare. Some of them, one of them is my cousin Danny, he has that like, Danny, he has that thing where he's just like, I want this, I want to do that, I'm going to work at it. He has a lot of discipline. My cousin Aaron, I look at him like that too, like, I like him, I admire him, the way he looks happy, but I feel like they have this thing where that side of the family doesn't believe that they don't think outside the box and hit go for the stars. Yeah. And I do.
I see.
But I have a little bit of doubt sometimes. And I think he was just like, let go of that doubt, bro. Let go. It's almost like when you're going to fight somebody, you're like, damn, man, he's probably going to beat me up. But this, just throw them hands, bro. Stop thinking about it. Just go in there and throw your hands. And you'll see that you can make things happen. When you get hit and you're like, oh, shit, you're in the fight now. You're not like, oh, you're like, oh, yeah.
You're in
and
it.
You start digging. And when you start digging, you make things happen. Mm. And I feel like that fight is life. I was a strong, skinny little kid. I used to do weird things. Not weird, but like I would do things that was abnormal. Like I would grab a guy your size and pick him up in the air and toss him. Like, you're like, how did you do that?
Oh, you were a bully.
No, I was just, I was no, no, no. I was a bully's bully.
Brunswick bully.
I like to find bullies. Because I used to get bullied a lot when I was a kid.
Oh, okay.
So you would take it out.
But anyway, I had the confidence, and I knew I can grab you, pick you up with you trying not to let me, pick you up in the air, and throw you somewhere. And it looked weird because I was a bone. So I had that confidence, and I lost it.
Why?
Life.
You lost it at a young age, or what?
Why does a knife get dull? You know, you use it too much, and it gets dinged here and there, and then it's not as sharp. I felt like I lost it in time with doubters. They start to weigh you down. And then you start to mess up, and you're like, damn, they were right. When you mess up here and there, damn, can't do it. Try. So you doubt yourself. That's why a lot of people aren't successful.
Well, speaking about that, man, talk to the people real quick before we head out about what we were talking about earlier about supporting on the low.
I think
we need to talk to all y'all.
I think, guys, I get people coming up to me telling me that they watched a podcast and that the podcast was cool and the podcast was this and the podcast was that.
Yes,
come
sir.
Here, come here.
The sound of alarms.
Embrace the podcast by supporting us also.
Yes, sir.
Putting a like. Yes, sir. Putting a comment.
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's cool.
You know?
Yes, sir.
Anything, an emoji. But if you guys just bypass it, it makes us seem like, and we're going to feel like, it ain't working.
Facts.
Just but then when people feedback. Come up to me, it's shocking. I get like, I'm like, wow, this person watched it? I didn't know. How would I know? Because he told me. But how would have I known without him telling me? Put a like.
Talk to him.
You know, but I had a lot of people that supported us, reshared my stuff.
We got a lot of reshares, actually. I was very surprised. We got a lot of reshares.
I posted it on my Facebook, the Instagram. People were like, yo, I want to watch more. Because I have a lot to talk about, and I feel like we do. It's not the Sammy Style show here. This is a family affair now. This is a different family. You got different families, right? You got your brothers and sisters. You got your parents. You got your cousins. You got your aunts, uncles, your nieces, nephews, your kids. Your kids' cousins.
Your kids' cousins?
Yeah. So we got, this is a different family now. This is what we're doing. So if people are going to support us, like it. You don't got to reshare it. Like it. Put a thumbs up. It's just a click, bro.
Or
but
a comment.
You're gonna watch it and then step off. That's whack, bro. Yep. Then when you tell me that, I'm gonna be honest. When you guys tell me that, I'm a little turned off. Like, damn, where's the love at?
Nah, you're gonna ask him. Hey, did you comment? Let's check it out.
Hey,
and then we're gonna have to see that.
Let me tell you something. If I come to your house and you cooked a dinner, if I was a meat eater and you cooked a T-bone steak. Cheese, eggs, and Welch is great. If you cook a steak and baked potato and all this, and you put your work into it, and I eat it, and I'm like, all right, bro, I'm going to check you. Peace. You're going to feel like, yo, what the hell? You want somebody to compliment the chef. You want them to burp and say, yo, that was bomb.
Yep.
Right? That's how we get complimented by likes. It's it's nice for them to tell me that, but I don't know if you telling me that because you just saw me face to face and you feel like you got to say something.
Like to spark a conversation.
Show me with actions and click that button. Because if you don't click the button, you're not feeling it. Because if you like something, you click it. If you wasn't married and you saw a girl with a bomb body on some social media platform, you're going to like it.
They're going to double tap that screen.
So tap that like button when we share this. We came here to share with you guys.
Facts.
We didn't come here just for us. I'm not making a dollar on this. I'm here. I'm losing. I spent gas, time coming here away from the family to give you guys entertainment. Show us that you like it. By hitting the like button. Do not just tell me. Because if you tell me, I'm like, you half-ass. You came up short, dog.
Show me. Don't tell me.
Yeah. Basically, I took you out to dinner, and you're like, you want me to put it on there? Nah, man. Throw that money up. Nah, that's, we putting that towards that. Show that support, man. And I'm going to start a GoFundMe, too. Put that money in that account. Because if you don't, you have to go to Ski Mask. Shane. Yonkers.
That's going to be Shiesty.
Bully.
Yes, sir.
Shiesty. Yeah. But no, you got to support us, and we're going to do a GoFundMe. You'll see. And we'll see even more support. And if you don't support, so be it. But more than likely, people will support you when you made it.
Yes, sir.
But that's not support. That's dick riding. That's what that is.
Shame.
Made it. It is.
Right now.
That's what they're doing. If they like you when you made it, and they try to get on you when they knew you when you didn't make it, that's dick riding, bro. Yeah. And you ain't getting shit.
That's that California shit, man. Talk to them.
Yeah. So you know, honestly, California does show love, So I see California sometimes showing more love than New York. But my New York people that I grew up with, that's like family, that's different.
You know what's crazy is that because I'm able to see, you know, the behind the scenes stuff, and a lot of people was watching that podcast from New York. Actually,
well,
so either it's the people who follow
Facebook, and those are a lot of New Yorkers that reshared mine.
So then their
New York people watched it, and it kept going from there.
So now you got to tell New York people to subscribe.
But they was also bigging me up because they knew me from when I was Sammy. I wasn't a Broad Street Bully in New York or none of that. I was a kid that liked to play basketball, loved playing Street Fighter 2, couldn't get a girlfriend to save my life because I had no game. I was shy as hell and I didn't talk to them, but I was a talker and I had fun with people and I tried to just always be around and have a good time.
I think that's a good topic next time for the next one. What? We need to talk about how Sam's going to give us three pointers next episode on how not to be shy for those guys out there right now who are shy. How you said, who can't talk, maybe don't have game, not even game, but just life, you know, life in general to
break
go
out their show.
Yeah.
They probably have everything but the balls to lay it down on the line.
Yeah.
And because they fear something. Like I feared being imperfect. I feared him being made fun of or rejected. I feared on just dropping the ball in front of you looking stupid.
I feel like I had to be perfect all times. So I was like a perfectionist. To
do, you can't be perfect all the time.
I don't
time.
Do that now. Yeah, I did before.
That's how
facial
I was too.
Expressions, everything.
Yep.
Yeah, the smell.
Even you know, even
cologne, bubble gum.
Yeah.
You even know, mint
even
gum.
Even this, it take in the beginning. Nah, I guess not anymore. But now I don't care. Now I really don't care. Like I could look crazy. Last episode, I thought I looked crazy. I didn't care. I just posted that shit.
I always think I look crazy, but who gives a shit?
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Giving it to you real and raw. That's all it is.
We're doing it, man.
Or I could look fly as hell, and I come in with makeup on and this and that, and then when you see me in public, you like, yo, this. I'm saying like to erase blemishes.
Yeah, just to come in perfect. You know?
And then when you see me in public, yo, this dude look like a. You know what I'm saying? I've seen people that look, you know, some catfish people. Yeah, they look jacked or girls or this and that. Bro. And then you see them in person and they're embarrassed. They don't look the same. They got to face the mirror. Mirror, mirror on the wall. You know what I'm saying?
They did too much Photoshop.
Well, you know you're going to judge that. If you see me, everybody knows I'm vegan. If you saw me
at Wild Wings, and
I'm eating some wings, and I'm greasy, and I got Parmesan cheese on my chin hair. Like, you're gonna be like, "Oh, this dude's
Dude, I used to, fuck with him all the time. One time I did actually see his car, and I saw that.
The
car.
First time it got me mad.
Yeah.
The first time I was like, what?
You caught this nigga eating chicken? But, no, but
I would just send him texts. Just,
he said, yo, somebody told me they saw you at.
Yeah.
He said somebody saw you at the, what's that steakhouse?
Outback.
Outback Steakhouse. And I was fighting wars at the time. He didn't know it. So damn. I got mad. I was like, who the fuck said that? Because I was getting arguments with people over being vegan. And I was like, yo, I'm living the best life. I can't believe this. And they were like, ah, I don't know. I'm going to need at least my chicken. I don't know. You eat vegan. And I would like try to explain to them why. And I soon learned, don't worry about it.
You don't gotta
explain that to nobody. You know who I want to explain to? The people that are looking for help saying, yo, man, I would like to be vegan, man. Can you help me? What is it? But the people that don't, I'm a waste of time, bro. We don't need to argue about it. I don't need to tell you nothing. I get zero from it, but irritated. And there's been some
he's irritated right now.
Yeah. Almost altercations over it. Passion. And then he sent me. And then my homie's like, yeah, yo, I heard back. You was at the Outback. I was so mad.
Danny, you trying to stir up the pot right now. Like, yo, yeah. I heard you got this man heated for no reason. And then he started
doing that on a regular.
Yeah, I would text him random. I'd just be like, hey, yo, somebody just told me that they saw your ass at fucking Outback.
Somebody said they saw you at Subway eating a Philly cheesesteak.
Yeah.
But I think he just wanted to see a reaction from, that's what from he does, New though. York that's Sammy Styles.
This man over here was at what, Five Guys? I'm like, bro, I'm at your job. Where you at? He's a stalker, bro.
No.
He definitely was hitting me with some, he was jabbing me when I least expected it. But the first one was a hard hit because I never knew I was going to get punched. I was like, what? Who said that? Like, yeah, nah, some people, and he was doing a Yonker shit on me, dog.
Niggas straight from New York now, this man ain't Cali.
But it was hard to catch on because he started swinging. I didn't even have a mouthpiece. No, I was being swung on.
But one time I did see your car at Carl's Jr., right? I was in the drive-thru. I went out. I saw his car at Carl's Jr., but I don't know who was driving. I don't think.
It was probably my fiance was probably going
Because you and her were at. And then after.
I let my car out sometimes too.
Yeah. I think it was an older lady maybe. I don't know who it was. I can't even say.
You sure it was his car?
It was his car because he has the fucking Puerto Rican thing. So I seen it and I was like, no.
Was it the Benz or the Acura?
Acura.
That was probably my fiance's mother.
Maybe because
I let her use my car when her car was getting worked on.
Yeah, so I was when I seen it, I was like, no, I really did catch his ass.
And then
later that day I saw his Instagram stories and he was like down below, him and his whole family. So I knew it wasn't him. But it was his car.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh shit, I caught his ass.
That happened to me before though. I went vegan one time before and everybody knew me for that when I lived in New York, in Albany. I went vegan and I took my son out and I was separated from his mom and I was trying to give him a good time and I didn't want to make him feel less. So I took him out to eat at one of my spots. And they have the ill Philly cheesesteaks there and all that. Ooh, and I started, it's ill. And their wings are crazy. They have moonshine wings. My man, I
moonshine
swear to God.
What is that?
I do miss that. It's just a certain sauce. And on a certain day, they sell them for cheaper. But you cannot take them home. You got to eat them there. Whatever you don't eat, got to go to the garbage. They're not giving you a doggy bag.
What?
You got the special. Jeez. Yeah, they're fire as hell. Yeah, anyway, man. I took them there and I started eating. And I said, yo, I'm just going to eat. I didn't go vegan that long. Now I've been vegan for over a year. This time I was like vegan for like, you know, a month. And so I was putting trying it out everywhere. I was like open off of it and this and that. And I was working out every day and I felt crazy. And people were on it because I used to be on social media hard. And I had a strong following. And I was eating out.
This is when you lived out here?
Nah, this is in Albany, New York. Okay. And I'm eating the
East Coast, nigga, listen, you ain't paying attention.
I'm eating that Philly cheesesteak, baby. Fuck. And I'm eating it. And I seen people that saw me that follow me on social media that look up to me.
You're like, aren't you a vegan?
They didn't say nothing. They were too embarrassed for me.
They're like,
they were embarrassed
fake.
For me. You know what I mean? You ever seen somebody and you put them on a pedestal and you see them out? They're not like that. You're like, oh, fuck.
You're not really like that.
I feel
that.
Bad for this dude. He acts like he's a pimp. His girls tell him, shut up and get in the car. You're like, get in the car. I felt embarrassed. fuck. He was, you know, like the pirate. The we saw that one time. We ain't going to get into that. But yeah, I just felt embarrassed for that person. Like, and they felt embarrassed for me at that time.
Hey, real quick, tell me about the New York pizza, man.
Is it different? New York pizza, bro. Brick oven. This pizza comes out with the bottom.
Yeah. Crispy.
Is thank you. It's a thin, hard layer of crisp. So when you take that pizza, right, and you got that, you got a lot of oil on it from the cheese and the sauce is in there, so it looks orange. Oh. And when you take it and you bend it in half,
yeah,
it don't flop down.
Nope.
It's straight out and the tip is coming down because it's so hot. The cheese is melting off of it. And you just, you suck that oil with the cheese. And you bite that and you burn the inside of your mouth. That's what you do. That pizza is so good. God, you got to eat it fresh right there.
The dough is different out there. Something.
Well, because of the water.
I don't get the water.
The dough is made with that water. And so is the cheese. So it tastes different, brother. But I'm not going to lie. You find your ways. And I found my way with Blaze Pizza.
Oh, that's right.
They got that's the, all I really got over here. That tastes pretty good. Close and I know it. How to make Blaze Pizza, a vegan pizza, and it beats your pizza. Trust me, it's so fiery and juicy. We all need to have it.
So break down your Blaze Pizza order. What you get?
Blaze Pizza, the high rise, which is vegan. It doesn't have egg or milk in it.
Cauliflower?
Get the high rise. Nah. No, regular high rise. No cauliflower. High rise dough. And you get, and I get that with... I tell them when they, what kind of sauce would you like? I'm like, let me get the red sauce. And they put it, but they only put one. And it usually is dry.
Mm.
So I'm like, when they finish with, before they even do it, can I get pesto sauce on the crust part?
Oh my God.
Funny. They take that brush and they put it in there and they paint it. Oil Lord with have green,
mercy on them.
Right? And once they do that, I'm like, yo, let me get the regular sauce. And they take the ladle and they fill it up with regular sauce and they pour it and they start to spread it out and flatten it out. But then it gets so thin that when that pizza gets cooked, it's a little dry. So I let them finish. When they finish, I'm like, I got to fake it.
Yeah.
And can I get some of that spicy sauce you got, the red spicy? And then they go to grab it and they kind of put like half a ladle. Still good. Boop. Drop it on. They spread it out again. Eesh. Now that pizza is covered in a red sauce. It ain't like lines of clear dry spots.
Yeah.
And then when it dries up even more. Nah, it's all red, baby. And then I'm like, ooh. Yo, they're like, what kind of meat would you like? Or cheese. I'm like, none. Kind of meat? None.
What?
Go to the veggies. Let's go to the veggies. Yeah, right to the veggies,
they don't
bro.
They got no vegan cheese there. No.
I'm telling you, fire. I don't want the vegan cheese. It's whack. No cheese. Really, nah, trust me, it's juicy as hell.
Because... the vegan cheese really don't melt like that.
You put leaves on it.
Nah, it's funny style, bro.
It really don't melt.
It's gonna kill it.
It's like fucking rubber.
It's like this. You could drink. You ever drink a diet soda and it tastes like a medicine?
Oh, that shit's nasty.
I'd rather drink water, bro.
Why
am I gonna drink that?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Why am I gonna drink something that I'm like, this is nasty?
Hell yeah.
I drink water.
So,
I don't want salsa. I don't want nothing. Diet. I'll drink water, or let me get that soda with that sugar in it. I'm sorry.
Facts.
But even though it's not good for you.
Sauce,
so
no cheese.
I put the sauce, put some red peppers on it. Yo, put some basil on it. Put some spinach on it. I'm like, yo, put some tomatoes. Now remember, the tomatoes going to make it re-pop. So when it gets cooked and you bite into it, it's going to have still another juiciness of it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Put the tomatoes because you got thick dough, remember. So put the tomatoes on it, put onions, give me two portions of the bell peppers. They got that little vinegary taste.
Mm.
Give me two portions of artichokes, put it all on it. Let me get the roasted garlic, the big pieces that are roasted.
Mm.
Let me get some more, put more. Let me get some chopped garlic. It's all watery. Put their hand in there with that thick, that big baggy glove, a plastic glove, and they spread it. And then I'm like, at the end, they have sauce there with a ladle at the end. I'm like, yo, let me get some of that sauce. And they take that sauce on top of all that.
And they dump it on top.
Oh, no. Hold up. And pineapples.
You already threw me off with the pineapple.
Lord.
I don't do pineapple.
Oh, you don't?
I do pineapples. Yeah, I do pineapples.
But I put it, boom.
Yep.
Juicy. And then I have them put, they take that sauce and they put a big round circles of sauce, like bloop, 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 bloop around it. They leave it like that. And then Let me get a little sprinkle of salt, a little sprinkle of oregano, and they put it in there, and that thing's cooking, and the crust is all big. But the crust, now since it was uncooked, it has that pesto, and the pesto kind of like soaks in, and it's shiny, and it's hard crust, and it comes out like a thick, and the whole thing is thick, and it's juicy, man. When they bring, and as soon as it's done, I'm like, yo, let me get some more pesto sauce on it, and they drizzle it like this.
They're probably like, this man is too much. Like,
God damn. Favorite, bro, it's so good.
They probably know you by now.
So good. But being vegan, and you eat that with that dough, and you keep eating that every day or twice a day, you will get big. So, you know, that's when I treat myself.
I've seen some big ass
like
vegans
that.
Before.
For sure.
Not going to lie.
They eat a lot of carbs.
Pasta.
Yeah. And so then that turns into sugar, which, you know, attaches. You and
imagine someone saying I'm vegan, and then they're like big. Like, and then so people probably won't even believe them. Like, you're vegan.
They eat a lot of carbs, a lot of pasta, a lot of white rice.
You eat a lot of pasta?
No, but I like pasta. But I watch my figure. Once I start getting a little out of shape, a little more, it's like a bell goes off and I get bothered and I look at myself in mirrors and I'm bothered and I'm like, got to do something.
Then he starts doing two a days.
Yeah, and diet, but if I run, I'll shred up.
Do the bike, man.
I saw the secret in shredding up, and I tried it because I was never a runner, and I was like, wow, my body changed daily between diet. I was eating super clean. I wasn't even eating pasta, none of that.
No sugar,
no pasta, no bread.
Oh yeah, bread's bad.
All, you know, good stuff, greens, beans, getting my protein from my beans and nuts, and I kept it super clean, and I was running 4 miles a day.
My boy,
was getting so lean and built, and people were like, yo, but vegan, you can't get your protein. I was like, yo, I'll take off my shirt right now. I bet you I got my muscles lean. Matter of fact, nah, I don't even do that. Let's go to the gym, and I'll bet you I'll do you. I'll run you to the ground.
Danny, jeez. We got to get on the Sammy.
Sammy vegan diet. Yes, sir.
I don't know about the vegan.
Between all that, yo, when I go to the gym, I was like, people were coming up to me like, yo, I don't know. Like, I didn't know anybody. Yeah. They were like, dude, one guy was like, hey, man, you're making me tired watching you. One dude was like, yo, man, what are you, a professional fighter or something? People were coming to me. This guy was like, hey, man, I was talking about you and my daughter. I don't know. Well, what do? You box? You do jujitsu or something? Mixed martial arts? I was like, yeah, I do jujitsu, but I'm doing this for my health, not for the sport.
You're doing it for
my health. And I felt like I was a superhero, bro. Sheesh. Going crazy.
Hey.
We got more to share.
Yeah, man. So I guess on the next one, we're going to hit that tricks and tips and how to be a better, more confident man.
I think we should. I think that will help
and
a lot Sammy's of
people. And Sammy's going to, tell us how to do that because he's been there, done that.
I got ways.
Yes, sir.
Remember, everybody works differently, but I'll give you my way. And then I like to give different angles of things.
The so Sammy way, not it. The Aki way.
For real. The Poppy way.
All right, man. We're out. We're going to close this up. Make sure you guys do not go run into Sammy at the gym talking about I watched your podcast.
And not show
exactly.
Yo,
exactly.
Screenshot that. Yep. Save it to your photos, and when you talk to me, I want to see that.
Facts.
Or you could hit them with, let me see if you're subscribed.
Yes, sir.
Let me see your phone.
Something.
Smash that subscribe button.
For real.
Yes, sir. All right, man. We're out. Make sure you put cheese on your pizza, pepperoni, and all that.
Chill out, nigga. You dumb.
Vegan power, baby.
All right. Yeah.
Rapping is my hobby. My house has a lobby.
The Empire.
Snobby, because I feed them thousands. I know that the end rhyme, but I'm only being...